I love writing code, but if you're anything like me, then creating even the most sophisticated logic for your apps seems easier than crafting a great user interface. Designs evolve over time, and testing every single change in your layouts on devices can be tedious. Enter the Layout Editor, a tool built into Android Studio that lets you edit and preview your layouts in real time, without the need to recompile and deploy the APK onto an actual device or emulator. The Layout Editor automatically kicks in whenever you open an XML layout file. The Design View lets you easily add and manipulate components by dragging them from the palette onto the stage. Visual Cues help you position views relative to each other, taking into account the parent node's class and required layout parameters. You can edit other view properties in the inspector, or change the view's place in the hierarchy in the component tree pane. There's a handy trick you can use when you've set up a view but then decided you want to change its class. Just right-click a view and select the desired component from the morphing menu. Be aware that there are certain restrictions in place to only allow changes that make sense, so you won't be able to morph a linear layout into a text view, for example. Whenever you see that parts of your view hierarchy can be reused in other layouts, there's also a refactoring called Extract Layout. When you enable it, the subtree you selected will be moved into a separate resource and included in your current layout. When you open the new file for editing, you can see it's still shown embedded in the original hierarchy for previewing. That's because Android Studio added a special hint to your XML when it performed the refactoring. To see it, let's switch to editing raw XML by pressing on the Text tab. Notice how instead of the visual editor, there is now a live preview window that updates in real time as you work on the code. If you always prefer to see code instead of the default design view, just enable the Prefer XML Editor option here. The hint for the renderer that I mentioned before actually consists of two parts. First, we have the new tool's namespace on the root XML node. The other is a set of special annotations that don't affect the runtime, but are processed by Android Studio. Here you can see the Show-in property that renders the file you're working on in the context of another layout in place of the include tag. It's certainly useful, but there's another type of hint that really boosted my productivity that I wish someone had pointed out to me sooner. You can actually override most of the view properties just by prefixing them with the tool's namespace. Seems simple, but look at how it can work for you. Ever had a layout with blank text views because it needs an adapter to supply data, like in a list view, for example? Add dummy text using the tool's namespace and make your layout immediately readable. What if parts of your layout are set to gone or invisible and only shown depending on runtime conditions? Just override it with tool's visibility for design time. As you can see, the Layout Editor is a fantastic tool and it's available in Android Studio. If you want to learn more or if you have any other layout editing tips, share them on Google+ in the Android Studio community. Be sure to check out the other videos in the Android Studio DevBytes series.